Good morning, children. Stay home and be safe. Welcome to Visual Classes. Myself, Rajashree Prahlad, handling 5th Standard Social Studies. Today, my topic is about the globe. So, where we are living? We are living on the Earth. Earth is the home for all living beings. So, this is called Earth. Earth is our home to all living beings. It has both land masses and water masses on its surface. Both land masses also and water masses also are there on its surface. So what is called atmosphere? The envelope of air is called an atmosphere. The envelope of air is called an atmosphere. And what is the surface of the earth? The surface of the earth, 70% of the earth's surface is covered with water and rest 30% is covered with land. So this is the surface of the earth. And what are called continents? The huge land masses are called continents. The huge land masses are called continents. And what are called oceans? The huge water bodies are called oceans. Continents and oceans. So here continents covered with land masses, that is mountains, plateaus, hills, plains and desert. These are covered by land masses. And water bodies are covered by seas, bays, gulfs, rivers, lakes and etc. These are covered by water bodies. And how many continents are there? There are seven continents. So what are the seven continents? Asia, Africa, Antarctica, North America, South America, Europe and Australia. These are the seven continents. In this, which is the biggest continent? Asia is the biggest continent. And which is the smallest continent? Australia is the smallest continent. And which continent is called as a dark continent? Africa is called as the dark continent. So these are the seven continents. Let's move on to oceans. How many oceans are there? There are five oceans. So what are the five oceans? Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, Southern Ocean and Arctic Ocean. In this, which is the biggest ocean? Pacific Ocean is the biggest ocean. And which is the smallest ocean? Arctic Ocean is the smallest ocean. So these are the seven continents and five oceans. So let us recall once again. What is Earth? Earth is our home for all living beings. So what is an atmosphere? The envelope of air is called an atmosphere. And in the surface of the Earth, how many percent of the water covered with water? 70% of the earth is covered with water and 30% of the earth is covered by land. And what are called continents? The huge land masses are called continents. And what are called oceans? The huge water bodies are called oceans. So land masses are covered by mountains, plateaus, hills, plains and desert. Water bodies covered by seas, bays, gulfs, rivers, lakes, etc. How many continents are there? Seven continents. And how many oceans are there? Five oceans. So these are the things we have learned today's lesson. So let us move on to globe in next class. Thank you, children.
Good morning, children. Let us continue today's class. In previous class, we learn about the earth, what is the surface of the earth and what are called continents, what are called oceans and how many continents are there and how many oceans are there. In previous class, we learn about this much. So, in today's topic, we learn more about the globe. So, what is called globe? Have you seen the globe? So, this is called as globe. It is the model of the earth. So globe is called the model of the earth. And what it shows? What the globe shows? It shows earth. And here globe has two end points. Have you observed this? Two end points from North Pole to South Pole. These are the two end points, the North Pole to South Pole. And there is an imaginary line joining here from. There is an imaginary line joining from North Pole to South Pole. It is called as an axis. The imaginary line joining North Pole to South Pole. It is called as axis. And here the halfway. See here halfway. This and here. Halfway between the North Pole to South Pole, another imaginary line. See here, this another imaginary line joined from North Pole to South Pole. This is called as an equator. What it shows? It divides the earth into two halves. It divides, see, imaginary line middle of the earth and imaginarily from North Pole to South Pole. What it shows? It shows that two halves from North Hemisphere to South Hemisphere. That is called as a globe. So next, move on to latitudes. What are called latitudes? The number of lines in this globe you can observe. The number of lines like this it has joined. See the number of lines parallel to the equator like this in the globe. You can see this number of lines parallel to the equator. I told where the equator will come. So the number of lines running parallel to the equator is called as a latitude. And here the other important latitudes are the Tropic of Cancer, 23 degree and off north, and the Tropic of Capricorn, 23 degree and off is south, and the Arctic Circle, 66 and off degree north, and the Antarctic Circle, 66 and off degree is south. So this is what today we learn about the globe and the latitude. And next class we learn about more properties of latitudes and longitudes. Thank you, children. Good morning, children. Last class we learn about latitudes. So what are called latitudes? The number of lines running parallel to the equator. These are the lines running parallel to the equator. These are called latitudes. And the other important latitudes are the Tropic of Cancer, 23 degree and off north, and the Tropic of Capricorn, 23 degree and off south, and the Arctic Circle, 66 degree and off north, and the Antarctic Circle, 66 degree off and south. So these are the latitudes. So what are the properties of latitudes? The equator is the largest latitude and also it is called the Great Circle. And the latitudes don't touch or cut each other. It won't touch or cut each other. All latitudes are complete circles. All the latitudes are complete circles except the North Pole and the South Pole. Except the North Pole and South Pole, which are points, and all the latitudes are located at an equal distance from each other. And there are 181 latitudes. How many latitudes are there? 181 latitudes. And latitudes are marked in degrees. We have mentioned here degrees, isn't it? So all the latitudes are mentioned in degrees and minutes, whereas 60 minutes, like that. So today we move on to the topic longitudes. So here longitudes, it is a semicircle running from the North Pole to South Pole. So it is a semicircle running to the North Pole.
right angles at 90 degrees. And the distance between two longitudes, the distance between two longitudes decreases as one goes away from the equator towards the poles. And longitudes are marked in degrees and minutes. And whereas 60 degrees 1 seconds, like this. So these are the longitudes and the properties of longitudes. Let's move on to the grid. What are called grid? The lines of latitudes and the lines of longitudes. That means the lines of latitudes and the lines of longitudes intersect each other. They both intersect each other at the right angles, forming a grid. Both intersect with each other. The lines of longitudes and the lines of latitudes, both the lines intersect each other at the right angle, forming a grid. And what it helps the grid? It helps us to locate a place on a globe or a map. What it helps the grid? It helps us to locate a place on a globe or a map. That means if we know that Delhi latitude is 20.30 degree north and its longitude is at 77.12 degree east. So we can easily locate a point where these two lines cross each other. So this point will give us the exact location of Delhi. So exact location it helps us to locate in a place on a globe or a map. That is called as a grid.